Every time you sit down at a computer, you kind of have to trust that it's going to do what you expect. Whether it's that you type your email and you trust that it's only going to go to the person you as the addressee, or whether it's you're receiving your bank statement and you trust that what you see on the screen is really what the bank knows about your transactions and your current balance. And in order to do that, you have to rely on a vast number of components, both in your own computer and in the network and in the servers at the other side of the network. And one thing that we know goes wrong is that computers catch viruses. Computers have people breaking into them electronically and changing the way that they behave. So this field of trusted computing has developed, which is trying to think about how to make the design be changed in such a way that that can't take place. In the past, we've tended to keep most of our data and our documents and all the things that matter to us on a hard disk on our own computer, or perhaps on a server that's on our local network within the building where we're working or something of that sort. That's turned out to be not as efficient as having a whole lot of computers somewhere else.
Thanks to today's supercomputers, like this Creese,
we can share those servers when some people are asleep, other people are working, and all those things. So the cloud can actually be a very green approach to computing. But the downside is, if I've got particular data that I value for myself, or if I'm processing somebody's private data and I've got a strong legal obligation to process it carefully and fairly and safely, it's much harder for me to know whether that's actually happening. If it's on some server in the cloud, and there may actually be a copy of it in Ireland and in San Francisco, when I've got no further use for it, I still have no guarantee that when I press delete, it will actually get deleted. It may persist forever because somebody else may find it useful, or they may carelessly fail to delete it when I ask them to. I need to protect my data, my processing, my resources from the other users of the same cloud resource. I'm actually sharing that server with another company who might be my competitor. I need to be fairly sure that my competitor doesn't get my data. And so I somehow need the server to be good enough to make sure that doesn't happen. The idea behind the T-Clouds project was to do this work of making sure that the software running on a server in the cloud is exactly the software that I wanted. And in fact, only releasing the data that might be quite personal or commercially sensitive when I've got a guarantee that it's actually running the right software.
It's a two-way authentication. So what you'll all be familiar with at the moment is if you do online banking, you go in, you authenticate yourself to the bank doesn't really do the same to you. So we have a bunch of technologies designed here in Oxford that solve that two-way, that piece.
Alongside that, you need lots of other pieces for the trust story. You need to know who the service provider is and what kind of policies they have around staff behavior and server management and who gets access to the room where all the servers are and all sorts of other things. But all of those things sit in the background compared to making sure that you've actually got the right software running.